and possible virtual intensive application, so each ITS module should provide either knowledge-based responses or intelligent procedure acting on the learner's environment. And finally, the requirement for ITS model should be as much as possible compliant to e-learning standards to grant their interoperability with other learning environments. So to give responses to these requirements, for the requirement 1 and 2, we have decided to choose an auto-configurable middleware. As in an example, the OSGI-based middleware can be the fitted solution. To answer the requirement 3, we need more semantics, namely for larger presentation, linguistic and visual features, and automated and dynamic composition and execution of OSGI services, and to give response to this requirement, we have based our solution on semantic web services features. And finally, for requirement 4, proposed ontologies should be based on existing learning standards. As an example, EMS learning information package as a standard for modeling the learner profile. So, I will explain some concepts and features for the OSGI platform. The fundamental concept of the OSGI platform is the bundled concept, which is the packaging format used for delivering software components. And each service on the framework has an interface and has an activator. So every time we have a new service, the framework will detect the arrival of the new service and will launch it automatically. And here we present the life cycle of each bundle, OSGI bundle. The service or the bundle would be installed. It should be resolved automatically. So if there are references needed by the service, they will resolve it automatically. Then the bundle will start and it can be active. We can stop it or install it, and the cycle may continue. So, OSGI Advantage, it provides flexible deployment of API for controlling components lifecycle. It provides a cooperative model where applications can independently discover and use services provided by other applications running inside the same OSGI platform. And thanks to its packaging format, application could be much smaller, fine-grained. Now we talk about the semantics of OSGI. And to bring this semantic, we have aspired our work from semantic web service frameworks. And so we provide ontologies for domain terminology, goals, and services. Namely, when we look or seek about the service, we should get a goal, which is an objective of a user of the framework. So matching between goals and services will bring the dynamicity of the framework. Here is the proposal architecture, which is a layered architecture. On the lower layer, we have the JVM, the Java Virtual Machine. We have the OPR, which is the repository where we can find bundles. We have the management lifecycle service and security services. And in the middle layer, we have all the components needed for developing our ITS, namely the domain ontology with domain services, the pedagogical and ontology with the pedagogical services, and so on. Now, so, this framework can be used to build many examples of ITS. We can combine services and ontologies to obtain many examples of ITS. And his ontologies, which we have developed, for example, for the OGI source ontology, the main component is the capability of the source. When we describe the source, we describe it over its capability, and so when we seek on a source, we must seek matching between the capability and the goal which the platform should achieve. Here is the goal ontology, and also we have the goal and capability matching. Here is the situation ontology. We can notice that the situation ontology is compliant with the ENSLD standard, where we have learning activities. A learning activity could be conducted within a learning environment. The learning environment provides services and resources, and a situation, pedagogical situation, is composed of many learning activities, and each situation may offer a goal, an objective goal, and the achievement of this goal may lead to another situation. And this makes some density of the process. And activating OGI service will lead to update the situation ontology, and the cycle will continue at, and achieving all the objectives, learning objectives. To implement our solution, we have used IPUJO OGI framework for OGI service development, and we have used GINA plugin and Protégé for reasoning and ontology development. In this case, when the learner can connect to the system in initialized session, the system will propose a quadratic equation. The learner will solve the equation and send the results. The system will make evaluation and return feedback. For implementation of the system, we have many boundaries. Each component here is a small application with it, all its functionalities, and execution will lead to invoke several services using the ontology that we have developed previously. So let's suppose now that the teacher wants to upgrade his ETS by adding features related to more sophisticated assessment method. So the service publication manager will add a new service to the OBR, the repository where there are bundles, and update the corresponding ontology without starting the OGI framework. Here is the example. We start by these bundles which are activated, and here we have the bundle sample assessment. After upgrading, the assessment bundle has been added to the framework without restarting the platform. It was updated in an automatic manner. How it is that it is carried out? We have a listener. The listener will detect the arrival of a new service by an event, either an event for removing the service or an event for adding a service, and it will update the OBR and auto-configure the service ontology. As a conclusion, we can say that semantic web and OGI-based middleware have been proven that they are a good solution for the previously cited issues. And the proposed solution presents several advantages. It firstly allowed fine-grained service development and deployment at runtime. Secondly, it allowed the semantic discovery, composition, and execution of service. And it allows formal natural representation about the ITS components. As future workers, thanks to the underlying OGI framework, which is made into small devices, ITS based on our solution seem to be lightweight. And we aim, therefore, in the future to develop mobile device with constraints characteristics. I can say that mainly OGI is usually deployed in